There she is. She's in there.
She's doing so good. She's totally gonna hatch out. 28.
Except for those two. She hates those two.
Yeah. Yep. Those two must be bad.
I hope she stays on there. I think she has 35 days.
Ooh, that's sooner.
So she started about 5 days ago. So that's basically 30 days.
Okay.
He is super protective over her.
He is.
So about April 22nd, 23rd, my birthday.
Ooh,
birthday
nice.
Goslings. But Ethan's more of the bird man, so
yeah.
You're more excited about all these little goslings It'll coming.
Be fun.
Yeah, it will be fun. She doesn't want anything to do with us. So one thing I noticed though is that she didn't start sitting on them until she started pulling her feathers out. And adding to that nest that we already had.
Oh yeah, because down feathers are really good insulators.
Yeah, she liked the straw, but she wanted her own bedding. So once she did that, she was good.
That's how we'll know next time.
Yeah. Welcome to morning chores on the farm. Let's see if the goats can remember which way they're supposed to go. You never know with Tilly and Fern. Oh, there you got it. Stella and Luna have it down though. They know right where the food is. And the three littles, Willow, Winnie, and Tatum, oh, they've got it down too. The babies have to wait a little bit though until we get their moms milked out. It always makes me laugh at which direction they choose to take. They either go straight down or they make a beeline for the other way. It's all about trying to get to the feed trough as fast as you can. Now the babies can be let out and they love it. Salem is such a good girl, waiting patiently while we milk Fern. And yes, we've gone back to hand milking. It's just a lot easier. Tilly, are you wanting to go back in and feed your babies already? We gotta milk you first. We gotta milk. I'm so glad Tilly is such a good mama. I mean, it's so nice to not have to worry about that.
Hi, Salem. Hello.
You can go feed your babies now.
That's not the wrong way.
Okay.
Tilly, gotta go this way. Come on.
Come on.
Where'd she go? She's running. There you go. There are the babies. She's so funny. She comes in here and she doesn't want to feed them.
Nope.
Bye. There she goes. They being rough on you, Tilly? Gosh. And finally, Stella. Yes, guys, she's a little bit lopsided from nursing Astrid, but it is what it is. She'll even out next year when she delivers babies again. Though I don't know how she's gonna part with little Astrid. They are so closely bonded. And now for the bucks. Can't forget about them. They love their morning breakfast of hay and pellets. Normally at the end we'd gather eggs, but looks like every nest is taken up. So we'll let them be for now. We'll come back later.
Well, guys, I'm super frustrated and sad. Hercules didn't make it. He was doing so well. We were feeding him by the pan, but I was also tube feeding him to make sure he was getting enough. He seemed like he was responding and doing well. All of a sudden he just got weaker, just started being lethargic and passed away. The vet says there's nothing you can really do. Pigs always have a few that pass away, and that's just how nature goes with pigs. They have a bunch so that when they have the ones pass away, they still have a few left. He said there was probably just something wrong on the inside. The other six are all much, much bigger, much, much stronger, and they are definitely healthy and happy. Sorry, Hermione. You're such a good mom. Their little personalities are coming out though, because it's so cute. Pumba's just so lazy and likes to sleep. Merida's just always crazy and fighting with people. Gus is just always hungry. Dory's just always so curious and looking at stuff. Gaston just always chews my feet so hard.
Let me guess which one's your favorite.
Yeah. Elsa, so sweet. Most of the time. If you pet her on the ground, she's super
Oh,
sweet.
gotcha. Okay.
Doing a little dog training with Salem.
That's good. With the nicest pig.
Yes.
I just finished planting all the rest of the vine plants for the summer. They're not looking too hot, but hey, I grew them from seed, so I'm gonna follow through and plant them. We've got cucumbers that hopefully will grow up both sides of this trellis, a bunch of cantaloupe, and then of course some watermelon on the end. I think I'm gonna let the watermelon sprawl out into the grass instead of asking it to grow up a vine, but hopefully all goes well. And finally, I planted about 6 little red pepper plants all along the south side of the pond, and they'll get lots of sun here, so I think they'll do great. But I am most excited about these potato plants. You guys, look at that. After about a month, they finally sprouted, and I'm pretty excited about it. Now, I have tried to grow potatoes in bags, and I haven't seemed to have the same success as I've done in ground. So, I don't know, guys. I don't know if it's my watering. Maybe it's just too hot of a climate for them. In ground seems to work the best for me. The sad thing is, Lydia, we have to pick off all these little peaches.
What?
I know. Well, we have to thin it out so that they grow big. We never do that and then they stay super small, so we're gonna do it this year.
Okay.
We're gonna be brave.
We're gonna risk it.
Okay, let's do it.
So pick ones that are close, like this one, like how these two.
Yeah, so yeah, get that smaller one, take it off. Okay. Good job. And then those are fine. And then like down here.
The small one.
Mm-hmm. So my front yard orchard is looking amazing because everything is in bloom, and growing trees in Arizona is not easy, but we're starting to get to like year 5 of these trees, so I'm thinking that they'll do better this year. We've got about 20 different varieties of fruit trees in the front yard away from the animals so that they can't eat them, and we're hoping that this year will be our best one yet. This is our dwarf mulberry tree, and there are so many little berries getting started on this. So that's gonna be fun. Well, we've had our pond cleaned out. And Salem now is having a blast while it's all empty. We get so many leaves and debris in the pond and they get all stuck in between the rocks. And then as they break down, it creates just too much phosphorus in the pond. So we've basically got all that cleaned out and the plants are all trimmed. So we're good to go now. We can do another swimming season. The fish are up there in those little tanks with aerators, so they're alive. And now we just wait for it to get filled up again. She's so funny. This is so fun. Gotta show her the next shelf here.
Hey, come on. Jump up like a bunny.
Can you believe it's been 3 years since we built the pond? So we're excited because the plants are getting more mature with each year. It was harder than we thought to grow plants that were good for our area. So now I think we've got that down. We know which plants are good. Now they're getting more mature, so they help filter the pond and keep it nice and clean. So here's to another swimming season and year of maturity for the pond. And the pond won't just be for swimming, it'll also be for catching fish. Here they come. We'll see how big of a fish Dad got. Oh man. Should we help him or should we just watch him? Go help him.
Are they that big?
Big.
What if they jump out?
Oh my gosh, Kevin.
Those are huge.
Wow.
So do you have to, you just want to add water from the pond into here?
Yeah.
Okay. You want a bucket?
A little bit at a time.
You're gonna get it slowly to the top and then they're just gonna flop out.
Down, help him.
Don't be upside down.
Oh, yay. That's pretty.
How long the tail is.
Oh, so pretty.
So the guy was telling me if we want him to have eggs and reproduce, we probably have to take out the other catfish and stuff.
Oh, because they eat the eggs?
The eggs.
Well, that's not gonna happen, so.
Look, it's being friends with Thor.
Where?
Oh no, Loki.
Where's the other one?
Hiding somewhere.
Oh, he's over there.
What if the world had more of your smile? What if the wind could spread your love? What if your sweetness could reach everyone? There'd be no wars. Maybe the birds will sing about your heart. Maybe the trees will whisper the word. Maybe the sun will spread your joy to the ones who lost their hope. What if the wind could spread your love? What if your sweetness could reach everyone? There'd be no wars.
Well, don't take your shoes off.
Okay, CrossFit exercise.
One, two, three.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, look at all those roaches!
We should have brought chickens over here. We should have brought a ton of chickens. They all ran to hide under the tire. Oh gosh. Come on, chickens. Come on, chickens. Get over here.
He sees them.
There they go. Who wants to hold the books back?
I mean, I can't. Here, let me put Salem on this tree.
Yeah, yeah. Tie Salem to that tree. That would be good. All right. Me and Lydia will go in and try to distract the boys with our girlness.
What?
I don't know.
Maybe I can trap them behind this gate.
Okay. Okay, push, push, push. There we go. You got him trapped. Good job, good job, good job.
Sorry, Zoro, but you got to stay back here for a little bit.
Okay.
Got it.
Right in the middle over there. Okay, go ahead, Lydia. Go. Good job. All right, boys. We got a fun present for you. Watch out. Goats. Okay, go.
Go, go.
Oh. That is fun. That's going to be fun for them. Okay, who wants to get on it first?
Come on,
they're thinking about it. Oh. See, that's how you do it. You get on it.
Just like that. You got this.
I'm taller than you. Come on.
Oh, they're going to scratch.
Oh my gosh. They're just going to try and fight it.
This is so you guys can view the ladies better. But you shouldn't be able to jump out. That's just, that's way too hard. Are you excited about that, Winston? I think they don't understand what this is supposed to be for. Come on, do it. Yay! See how fun that is?
Oh, Zoro.
There we go!
Oh, he did it, Zoro! Good job. Couple days, they'll be jumping on and off it.
Oh, did you see that big jump?
Oh, I didn't see it. I was looking away. Thanks for joining us in today's video. If you want to watch the video where we first brought Carlisle and Esme home, click right here.